Today we're going to investigate three ways to save the same JSON file, but notice the changes in data types as the output for the file to parse. Here are the three outputs that we'll get. Welcome everybody, you're watching Mr. Fugu Data Science. We have a viewer submission today. Here's my socials, feel free to hit me up. All the code will be in the link in description below, and I will start posting it in the comment that's pinned in the bottom as well. I need to stress that because I had a message today that came up and it was kind of important, so I'm gonna place it in two positions to make it easier for people. What are we gonna do today? We will be parsing JSON, but there's some caveats when you're saving your files, for example, from an API or from wherever. And the structure of your data that's saved and the formatting are going to dictate how you parse later. What am I talking about? The client or the viewer that we had, this is the formatted file came in. This poses a little bit of a problem and you have to kind of restructure. These are all strings, but if you notice, we have dictionaries we need to parse. If you notice here, this is the same data saved differently. And you notice the dictionaries, which means that we're on the right track and we have this list. So we're going to do our two favorite techniques today. If you would like to try and follow along, feel free. You could always pause the video at any point you want. Let's investigate these data real quick to understand what we're dealing with. I was sent this file. When they saved it from the API, they didn't pay attention and it has this index column. That's not a problem. We could deal with that later. Let's look at what we have. We have a couple dictionaries we need to parse per usual, something that's empty, not a big deal. And we have to flatten the list followed by further dictionaries. Since these data are dealing with strings, meaning that we have to parse this and flatten the JSON, how do we manipulate this data since this is what I was given? Frustrating as it may be, saved as a string, we do have formatting that we can do. But why would something like this happen? Let's go to Pandas and look at this. When you're saving a file to a CSV, this right here is important because if you do not place anything within this and you just save the file, maybe you just make a generic file name, it saves it as a string. You can manipulate this and store it how you need, but the default setting is saving it as a string. That's what happened here when they pulled the data. Now, if I try my normal techniques to flatten this list column using Pandas Explode, nothing happens. You see this? Nothing happened because we're dealing with a string. Pandas Explode flattens list. The data type is a string. What are we going to do? I have a few ways if you would like to help support the channel. If you feel like I've done a service that provides help to others, I have a Buy Me a Coffee, channel memberships, and super thanks. This is the original data I was given by the viewer. Here's the API that we were calling. This is verbatim the code that I was given. This is what they wanted to save it under. They pulled this file, which was JSON format. Taking the outermost key and retrieving everything that was the key value pairs with inside of it. It looks fine, except right here is your problem. This is what stored everything as a string. You have to manipulate this so you can parse these data. And that's where they were a little confused and wanted some assistance and for me to make this video. Changing this to a different format by pulling the same data, saving it a little different. This is what I did instead. You could save it as a CSV, but since I know I have a JSON format, why don't I just take it and save it as a JSON file and orient equals records. This revision in the code helps you because now you're saving it in a proper formatting. And if you don't use that orient equals records, you're still going to retrieve the data in kind of a problematic way. If you save it as columns, for instance, you're going to have a different formatting for your data. I was able to do this in just a few lines of code to solve this whole problem. Since these data are now formatted in the correct way, we can use Pandas Explode to flatten out that list column, and every single column that has the dictionaries, we can now flatten it using json.loads, which stands for string, where we're converting our data for our data frame to JSON, orienting as records, and using the panda.json normalize to flatten this out. And we have no indexing on this column, which would have been this right here. So that saves us a lot of headache, right? It gave us the correct formatting here, which was giving us our dictionaries and our list. By doing that manipulation to the viewer's code for one line, changing the output for the file save. My version, if I was doing this, would have even reduced this further. I would have used the same exact two lines of code. I would have condensed it here where I'm taking the output, which is their data frame that we're going to store. And I just do a with open. So with open will create this file that I'm writing called toy.json1. I'm taking our iterator, which is this, and storing our JSON file and dumping this, which you can call later. And this for me was what I would have done initially. You could save it any various number of ways, but that's how I would have done this to save that headache for the output. Doing the same thing, the flattening of the list that we'll have here will still be the explode, and this will still be the JSON normalize. I just changed the output for how I would have saved the file if I were to do this myself. Everything else turns out to be the same. Take the explode, flattens out that list. Next one, we notice that if we were to look at the data types now from this list, this flattened list, we notice that we have all these dictionaries, and the one of these that was a list is now flattened into a dictionary. We take our data frame, convert it to JSON, orient to records, convert this JSON.loadString, and then use JSON normalize to flatten everything out. And that's it for these data. Running this, it's only a few lines of code, 14 lines of code, but really it's about 7 or 8 lines of code. It's like 8 lines of code. And that's it. Extremely simple in changing the way that you save the file.
I think it's kind of important for us to break this down real quick so we could get a little bit of an understanding if we're unfamiliar. Here's the API that we're going to call. We're going to print it off in a JSON format. Let's see what happens. Here's what we have. All of the data are stored within this content key. Here are the values as a list. It says that we're going to go from 1 to 1,000 postings. So let's go inside that list, or go inside and grab that list. Here's all of our values. Let's see what the length is. So we got 100 entries. I decided to store as this toy example for the JSON to create a file. But let's see what it looks like if you pull it directly as a JSON object into pandas real quick. So here's what we have. Now, this look is something. For example, one of the hangups that we had earlier was this for parsing. So let's look at this real quick. Let's pull the very first one. Okay, so that's fine. So this looks like we're dealing with lists storing all of our information, and it doesn't look like we're pulling a string. So it's a list. So from here, we should be able to take this directly, so we can flatten it directly like that if you did not want to save it as a file as well. So that's another option that you have. Let's just make up a dummy variable name, and let's verify that we can actually parse it with JSON normalize for our dictionary values. And look at that, you're good to go as well. That little trick is quite convenient. I saved it for last for everyone who would have scrolled past the video. And that was one last option that you have. Storing the file like this would have helped this person immensely with the confusion of not being able to parse the data because they were all strings. But I would like to say, please like, share, and subscribe. And if you subscribe, turn on that notification bell. Thank you to all the people who have helped give suggestions over the last few years. I have a few ways if you would like to help support the channel. If you feel like I've done a service that provides help to others, I have a Buy Me a Coffee, channel memberships, and super thanks. I'll see you in the next video. Thank you. Bye. Hey kid, don't ever let them get inside your head. They'll tell you what to do in life instead of everything you know that you could get. Don't let them guide your life towards regret.